Welcome to the Lionfish Tutorials, a series of how-to instructional videos covering collecting and handling, monitoring, and dissection. This segment will cover collecting and handling, including tools and techniques to increase the safety and effectiveness of your removal events. The marine environment is a diverse and changing habitat. Invasive lionfish are a recent threat to our native marine systems, and there is great concern over the impacts they are causing. The good news is that local control through regular removals can be very successful in keeping lionfish numbers down and minimizing their impacts. In this tutorial, we'll talk about diver removal efforts and the tools and techniques that are being used to control lionfish on our local reefs. For divers and snorkelers, there are two primary methods of lionfish removals: nets and spears. Each method has its advantages and disadvantages, and there are many styles to choose from. We'll examine some of the more common types and their uses. Though lionfish are boldly patterned and can be ornate in their fin displays, during prime daylight hours they are most often sheltered and cryptic in nature. When looking for lionfish, search thoroughly and explore overhangs, crevices, and sheltered areas. Lionfish tend to prefer high relief and complex structures, though they can be found in almost any habitat. While there are many types and configurations of collecting equipment, one of the most valuable pieces of gear is a pair of protective gloves to minimize stings. Lionfish have a formidable array of 13 dorsal, 2 pelvic, and 3 anal spines that contain a powerful neurotoxin venom. A first priority in any collection effort should be safety, and the use of specially designed puncture-resistant gloves should be a requisite for your lionfish hunt. It's important to note that regular diving gloves, and even those made for protection against knife cuts, are not effective at preventing penetration by the needle-sharp spines. Specially marketed puncture or stick-resistant gloves are highly effective at preventing spine-related injuries. We'll discuss first aid for stings later in this segment. The use of hand nets can be highly successful in areas where lionfish are accessible, where they've not been harassed, where fish may be smaller, where live capture for research is required, or where gear restrictions may be an issue. The two primary types of hand nets include mesh bait nets and clear vinyl collecting nets used by aquarium collectors. Clear vinyl nets are typically wide-mouthed and deep-bodied nets with a strong mesh bottom and are held open by an aluminum frame. These nets are often used by divers but are less suitable for snorkelers due to their drag in the water. These wide-mouthed nets can be highly effective even for large lionfish. However, their success depends on slow, deliberate movements and practiced placement and collection techniques. The most effective strategy for collecting lionfish with vinyl nets is to use a pair of nets either by yourself or working with another diver. When a lionfish is first sighted, give the hand signal and both divers should survey the scene. This initial assessment should include determining the possible escape routes of the fish, any environmental concerns such as sensitive corals or sponges, any potential safety issues such as overhead environments, and the location for securing the fish once it is captured. Good communication between divers is essential in determining net placement, movements, and other decisions during the collection. From a few meters away, deploy your nets and ensure that the bodies of the nets are well opened. All net movement should be very slow and deliberate, and you should be constantly monitoring the target lionfish for movements that might indicate its attempt to escape. The priority of the first net is to block the most likely escape route of the fish. Once the first net has been placed, move the other net or nets into place to surround the fish. Remember, it's imperative that the nets are moved slowly but deliberately to block the fish if it starts to move toward an escape route or gap between the nets. As the nets come together, the fish will typically swim into one net, and as it does, quickly move the other net behind the fish to trap it between the two nets, effectively sealing off any escape. In some instances, the lionfish may make a quick dart between or around the nets. In these instances, even though the tendency is to try to quickly reach after the fish, the best course of action is to let the fish move, reestablish a comfort zone, and then reposition yourself and the nets for a second collection effort. If the fish disappears into a cave or crevice, avoid poking, prodding, or otherwise attempting to scare the fish out of its hiding spot. Chasing or harassing the fish rarely results in a successful capture and can teach the fish to avoid divers, making future capture attempts more difficult. Following a successful capture, the next step in the process is to move the fish to a suitable area for transfer to a storage device. A sandy or algae-covered bottom is most suitable, and you should take care to avoid contact with sensitive corals, sponges, or other marine life. Numerous storage devices are available on the market, and many can be handmade from locally available materials such as buckets, PVC, or vinyl bags. For live captures, one of the preferred storage devices is a clear dry bag. These bags are typically made of heavy gauge clear vinyl. The bags can be rolled up and stored during the dive and deployed once the first fish is captured. When deploying the dry bag, ensure it is fully opened and all of the remaining air bubbles have been released. Once the bag is ready, place the nets containing the lionfish on the bottom, with the lionfish in the uppermost net. The bottom net can then be removed and placed nearby. The remaining net with the lionfish should be secured so that there are no escape routes underneath the net. Use a gloved hand to slowly collapse the net down on top of the lionfish so that it is positioned near the mesh portion of the net. As the net is further collapsed, the fish is unable to move and is held in place with the palm of the gloved hand. Next, reposition your hand so that you can firmly grasp the head of the lionfish from the outside of the net. Take care to properly position your hand across the face of the fish from directly in front of its mouth. Placement too high along the back or from above may lead to contact with the first dorsal spine, which can move quite far forward. Once the fish is firmly in your grasp, invert the net so that the body of the fish is now exposed in open water. The buddy in charge of the bag should hold the mouth of the bag wide open as the lionfish is placed into the bag. Remember to ensure that the spines do not contact either diver. All movements during the bagging process should be slow, deliberate, and carefully communicated. The diver holding the fish should extend the arm as far as possible into the bag, while the other diver firmly grasps his wrist. Once both divers are ready, the fish can be released. The fish will typically swim away from the grasp of the diver toward the bottom of the bag. Following this movement, the diver in charge of the bag lays a barrier across the bag while the hand of the grasping diver is removed. The bag is then rolled over and clipped shut. Successful capture. For subsequent captures using the same storage bag, multiple fish can be introduced simply by sliding the barrier down the bag to herd the captured fish away from the opening. Large dry bags can hold upward of 30 large lionfish. Once fish are in the bag, they are normally quite docile. However, be careful when working around the bag, as spines have been known to penetrate through the heavy vinyl. While large vinyl nets may work well for divers, a snorkeler is typically more restricted in the length of time available to make a capture. Many snorkelers have had great success in using smaller mesh bait nets due to lighter weight and significantly less drag through the water. Use of mesh nets during snorkeling entails many of the same elements as the use of vinyl nets for diving, including planning a strategy and blocking the escape route. However, the movement during capture is much more rapid in nature. Once the first net is placed, the second net can be moved quickly into position, and the two nets brought rapidly together with the lionfish in between. A rapid ascent following capture tends to force the lionfish down into the bottom net, and escape during ascent is infrequent. Take care, once you are on the surface, to keep the two nets together to prevent the lionfish from swimming between even the smallest gaps in the nets. Bagging lionfish on the surface can be a tricky affair, and most snorkelers choose to swim their fish to the boat to hand up to their surface support. During this transfer, do not hold the lionfish overhead and do not extend the nets directly towards the surface support personnel. Lionfish have been known to flip out of the nets when held out of the water, and severe injury could occur. While netting of live fish may be new to most divers, spearing is more widely known and can be highly effective for lionfish removals. Spearing may be faster than netting, especially in areas where lionfish can be difficult to reach, or in areas where the population is especially dense. The downsides of spearing are that misses can be somewhat common, and lionfish quickly learn to avoid divers. Spearing can also attract top predators and prove to be a safety hazard for divers in areas where predators have become accustomed to taking speared fish. Some locations, such as marine protected areas, may also have regulations against spearing. However, when and where spearing is allowed, it can be highly effective. There are many types of spearing devices, including spear guns, Hawaiian slings, pole spears, and numerous lionfish-specific devices. Fortunately for collectors, lionfish are quite bold, allowing a close approach and minimizing the need for large gun-type devices. Two common spear tips are free shaft tips and paralyzer prong tips. Free shaft tips may feature a toggle or simply a barren point. Paralyzer-type prong tips have multiple points to better hold the fish. When using free shaft type devices, take extreme care, as fish are able to move around as well as up and down the length of the spear. Many divers have been stung by lionfish sliding down the spear to the unsuspecting diver's hand. In contrast, a pole spear with a paralyzer tip prevents fish from sliding towards the diver, and when multiple prongs are in the fish, prevents the fish from rotating around the spear. Regardless of the type of gear used, the same general spearing techniques are used. Though removal of lionfish may be your primary objective, avoid damaging natural resources at all costs. Spearfishers should assess not only the lionfish and its position relative to successful capture, but also the surrounding habitat, including the area behind the fish, to ensure no other organisms or structures could be impacted. If the fish happens to be in a poor location, slowly and carefully move the spear to reposition the fish into a better location. The desired position of the fish is perpendicular or facing slightly towards the diver. Spearing from an angle behind the fish can result in misses due to the movement of the fish and the fact that the spear is moving the fish away from the diver. With the fish in a proper position, maintain neutral buoyancy, or steady yourself with one hand on barren substrate. Then ready your spear for release and move it as closely as possible towards the fish. Aim for the area just behind the bony head and above the pectoral fin. In some cases, you may be able to position the spear almost touching the lionfish. With the spear as close as possible, release the spear and keep the fish pinned to the bottom following successful impalement. Lionfish are hardy fish and are rarely killed during a single spearing event. Moving the fish away from the bottom provides opportunity for the fish to escape. With the fish held fast to the bottom and using the gloved hand, grasp it by the head in similar fashion to that described for net captures. While holding the fish by the head and still on the spear, it can be successfully transferred into the in-water storage device. When using dry bags for storage, the same procedure used for netting applies. Hold the lionfish on the spear until the fish is well into the bag. Then remove the spear from the fish. When the bagger is ready, release the lionfish into the bag and withdraw your hand. An advantage of using dry bags is that they also tend to contain any blood or body parts that could attract predators. Other storage devices commonly used in the region include buckets with scored lids, trap door devices, and specially designed tube devices with one-way funnels allowing fish to be introduced with minimal handling. When using these devices, hold the device securely or place it on the barren bottom to allow a forceful entry. Large fish that are speared head-on may need to be repositioned onto another spear so they can be introduced into the storage device head-first. Following introduction into the device, Sharply pull the spear out of the device, effectively stripping the fish from the spear. Watch out for protruding spines during this process. Finally, following a successful dive of lionfish captures, storage on the vessel should be considered. Using a suitable cooler or other device that will securely hold the fish is paramount. Store the lionfish separate from other foods or refreshment to reduce possible stings when reaching into the cooler. And if the fish are to be consumed, they should be well iced, though care in handling is still warranted as icing preserves the venom. When removals are well executed and divers are properly equipped, the risk of envenomation from stings is low. However, in the event of a lionfish sting, it's important to know proper first aid and treatment procedures. The most effective first aid is prevention, and the primary rule in lionfish collecting should be safety. Use of puncture-resistant gloves and proper collecting and handling techniques are important safety considerations. In the unlikely event of a sting, proper first aid procedures include safe completion of the dive. If the sting occurs during a dive, the diver should end the dive and make a slow ascent, including a safety stop. Rapid ascent or panic following a sting could lead to injuries much more severe than the sting itself. Once on board the vessel or on shore, the wound should be inspected for any trauma or debris, and the affected area immersed in non-scalding hot water. The venom of lionfish is a protein-based neurotoxin, and heat is thought to break down the protein base of the venom and relieve the pain associated with the sting. Most symptoms are isolated to pain and swelling at the sting site, though in rare cases, other symptoms may occur. If any other symptoms are present, or if soaking in hot water does not relieve the pain, medical treatment is advised. Lionfish collecting can be an effective method of controlling populations and minimizing impacts across local scales. Divers and snorkelers can play a key role in working with governments and researchers to protect native marine life. With these control efforts and evolving tools and technologies, there is hope in buying time and protecting key areas of high importance from lionfish impacts. For more information on lionfish control programs and events, visit the following websites. Safe and happy hunting.